Ladies and gentlemen, we're here with the famous Markus Schulz, one of the leading names when it comes to produce nowadays trance sound. Can I say it so?
If you want to say so, for sure.
I want to, yes. And you're a virus user, a virus owner.
For over 10 years. One of the first keyboards that I had was the virus, the original one.
Okay.
So I've always been in love with it. I mean, you know, it's funny because it was like, I always felt like the very first virus, it felt like it was at the tip of my fingertips. It's like it was the first keyboard that I ever worked on where when I thought about a sound in my head, I didn't have to think about how to make it. My fingers were just able to dial in the sounds. You're not even putting into words what you are trying to come up with. It's just your thoughts and a feeling, and yes. You just dial it right in.
Uh-huh. Awesome. Can you remember the first record that you used the virus?
Oh, I did a remix for Everything But the Girl, called Clubland. And that was the first one. I remember the bass line was right from the virus, and it was just like, I remember playing that that remix when I played in the clubs, and the bass line would just like shake the whole building. So it was like really big sounding and really thick, and I remember clearly. I'm thinking about it right now, the bass line. It was fantastic.
Awesome. So it seems that you naturally prefer hardware synthesizers.
Well, yeah, you know, but I travel a lot, so, I bring my laptop with me, and I do a lot of production on the airplane and in hotel rooms and stuff like that. But when I get back in the studio, it's like, you know, I reassign some of those sounds to my virus or other hardware, and to me, it's just like, it has a different sound. It's like the VSTs have a distinct sound, and the hardware, especially the virus, has its sound, and I absolutely love it.
How do you take your time out for producing?
Yeah, you know, usually I'm home on Mondays and Tuesdays. Those are like my studio days. Mm-hmm. Wednesdays is my radio show day. That's when I'm creating my radio show. And then on Thursdays is back on the road again. So usually when I'm on the road touring, I'm working in my laptop, but then Mondays and Tuesdays is when I'm in the studio. It's like, very disciplined studio time where I get in there and that's like my sacred time.
Okay. It has to be like that when you're on tour so much. You have to take some time out. Do you work alone most of the time?
Yeah, most of the time I work alone, but one of the things is the more you tour, with the pressure from the airplanes and thrashing your ears, doing 4 gigs a week in clubs, your ears get fatigued. So I do bring in engineers to help me with the final mix down, I think that I know what it is that I want, and I try and get it as close as possible.
Okay.
But then you have to have a second set of ears come in to just kind of fine tune, because sometimes you tuning hi-hats or something a little louder because your ears are fatigued from the weekend, and it doesn't work. So it's always good to have a second set of ears there.
What inspires you?
What inspires me is the fans. When I'm up playing in front of people, sometimes I'm in front of 50,000 people, and you get this energy from the fans. And, while I'm up there, I'm actually like getting ideas to get into the studio, when I get in the studio. So that's the biggest thing. And then when I'm in the studio, I'm actually visualizing playing these tracks in front of 50,000 people. So for sure, the fans are what inspire me the most.
So everybody, thanks a lot. Kids, if you watch it, that's the way you do it. Get inspired by the people, and bring it back to the people. Thank you. Thank you, Markus.
Thank you, guys.
Awesome. Thank you. Great.
All right. Cool.